Keith Burgan left his home in Australia more than 30 years ago to pursue his NHRA dreams. And during a visit to the 1988 Mid-South Nationals in Memphis, he landed a job with Paul Smith and Chuck Etchells.
Paul was crew chief on Chuck's funny car, but he also had his own top fuel car. And I was what would, I guess, now be called the car chief on the dragster. I was the crew. I was it. Just to come over here and be able to meet my heroes and become friends with them has just been really great.
Not long after taking that first job, Burgan picked up the nickname Kangaroo Man, which was shortened later to what he is known by today, Roo Man.
When I went to work for John Force in early 08, I got recruited to run his fab shop. When Bernie Federley told him they'd found someone to run the fab shop, Force asked who, and he told, well, Keith Burgan, you know him. And Force goes, no, I don't. And they went round and round for a bit, and eventually Bernie said, it's Roo Man. And Force went, oh yeah, I know him.
Nowadays, Roo Man spends most of his time in his own shop, building basically any kind of race car you could want.
Basically, I build all sorts of things. So right now, this is a junior dragster I'm doing for a customer in Boston area, and building it as a retro type junior dragster, like a very early rear engine top fuel car. I've got a front engine dragster. Recently, I've sort of specialized in that sort of stuff. It's what I grew up with. And I've got my own project up there as a Don Long car that's a restoration of a car from 1969.
Roo Man says it's the creative gene that drives him to make his race cars as close to perfect as possible. And it's also extremely satisfying to see one of his designs win. For the NHRA, I'm John Kernan in Indianapolis.